BC TV receives state arts funding support through a grant from the Pennsylvania Council on the Arts, a state agency. Funded by the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania and the National Endowment for the Arts, a federal agency.
Good evening and welcome to the monthly program of Berks Arts Council. Happy New Year to each and every one of you. We hope you had a wonderful holiday season. And we are so happy to be kicking off the new year with a lot of exciting events that are occurring here in the Berks County community. Tonight, we are going to be featuring the Alvernia Art Series with our special guest, Jessica Warchal-King. So welcome, Jessica.
Thank you so much.
You are just a breath of fresh air to have with us and within the Alvernia community, and we are just excited tonight to be able to feature the Alvernia Art Series. But before we do that, I do want to just share a few things that are going on within the Arts Council. Gave a little bit of a snippet last month, but it is very active now. It is the 30th annual Boscov's Barks Jazz Fest. We were pushing our tickets. Yes. Woo-hoo! We're super excited about Jazz Fest. Being our 30th year, we have such an amazing lineup, thanks to our general manager, John Ernesto. And we want to share with each and every one of you that tickets are still available. We've gotten a variety of phone calls in our offices saying, hey, are tickets still available? Of course they are. Tickets will be available up and through the festival, which starts March 27th. We'll be running it through April 5th. We have over 45 concerts that are planned in our major venues. There'll probably be another 40 to 50 concerts in our local restaurants, bars, retirement communities, and other locations, really, throughout Berks County. There's all types of places that are going to be involved in celebrating the 30th annual Jazz Fest this year. Our concert schedule is currently up on our website, which is www.berksjazzfest.com. And in the coming weeks, we're going to have our local event schedule being posted as well. Many of our local events are free for the community. Some have cover charges, some do have ticket sales. So we do recommend checking them out before you go so you know what to expect, particularly if it is a ticketed event. You can also look around our community. We do have these brochures that are going out and about. We've been mailing them as well. They're available in our office, at the Goggle Works, all of our local hotels, a lot of our local restaurants as well. So make sure you get your tickets to the Boscov's Berks Jazz Fest. Our opening concert this year is Chris Bode on March 27th. He will be performing at the Santander Performing Arts Center. Following the next night will be our 30th anniversary celebration, two amazing concerts. The 30th anniversary celebration is going to feature a number of artists from the past 30 years. So maybe your favorite artist might be coming back and will be part of that performance. Also this year we have coming back Boney James, which is a huge favorite of our audience. And this year we're closing with Brian Culbertson. Many years we open with Brian, but this year we're closing with Brian, and he'll be performing at the Scottish Rite Cathedral. So make sure you check out our full schedule. One of the more, I think, interesting, exciting components of Jazz Fest that maybe some of our community is not aware of is our Get Jazz program. And Get Jazz is for our local students. It's a program that focuses on providing our local youth an opportunity to participate in jazz education programs, performances, instruction, and exhibitions with local, regional, and national artists. And we're so thankful for the Reading Musical Foundation, Penske, Service Electric, Cablevision, and Coactive Wealth Strategies that helped to sponsor the hundreds of kids. I think it was over 500 kids last year. Wow. That participated in our Get Jazz programs. And they're starting very soon, like Saturday, January 18th. Thanks to Mike and Millie Eben and our Get Jazz committee, we're going to be starting off with our Al Seifert Instrumental Day over at the Y. Missing Junior Senior High School. We also will then do our Tony Lynn Vocal Day, which is Saturday, I think it's the next weekend. I have on here the 18th, which I know that is not correct. It's actually February 8th, is that's what that one's going to be, at Exeter High School. And we renamed those days. We just announced that we're dedicating our instrumental day to Al Seifert and our vocal day to Tony Lynn, who are just two amazing jazz musicians. Our big band competitions are on Sunday, March 29th at the Miller Center. We'll start at 1 o'clock with our middle school students and at 6 o'clock with our high school students. You want to see some amazing talent? Come to Doc Mulligan Day. You will not be disappointed. It's a donation at the door. Again, amazing musicians in our local community. Then on Monday, March 30th, this is an event I absolutely love. It's the Reading Musical Foundation Penske Jazz Jam. This is where our local jazz students can come over to the Inn at Reading, you sign in, and they can play with our Jazz Fest musicians on stage. And it is just incredible to watch our young students get matched with these artists, and they freestyle it, really, on stage. So if you're looking for a great event to support our local students, please come out and support the Penske Jazz Jam or a Doc Mulligan Day during Jazz Fest. And they are in our brochure as well, so make sure you check those out. So I just want to kind of give a little feature to those, because a lot of times Get Jazz isn't shared a whole lot, or it's seen in our brochure, people don't know about it. But it's such an important component to our local school system and to our local students that really want to learn jazz music. So please support our jazz students. So now, on to tonight's program.
Alvernia.
Yes, please.
That is a perfect segue.
Yeah, absolutely.
I love that Get Jazzed is really lifting up the voices of the young artists who are in and around the Berks County area, and that was my goal with the art series, to allow an opportunity for local artists to be featured on this concert stage in a way maybe they haven't been before, or maybe people didn't know that Alvernia was a place that had a concert venue.
Right.
So what I'm really excited about is being able to connect with so many people inside of the Reading area community through the art series itself. What we did in the fall was we had, excuse me, I get really excited. We had the Wheatland Chorale come, and they have members from five counties. They rehearse in Lancaster, but they perform all over Pennsylvania. They perform internationally. And one of Alvernia's own faculty members, Jenny Mahalik, who's also our choral director, is a part of that chorus.
Right.
So what I think was really exciting for me was to have some of Jenny's students be able to see her perform and engage in her professional scholarship and her professional practice, in addition to seeing her in the classroom. So many artists are working artists.
Right.
It's something that we do multiple jobs. We have multiple gigs. We do different things. And one of those things is performing, and sometimes one of those things is teaching. And I think it's so important for young people to see the possibilities of a professional artist. And so that was my hope in developing this season of the art series at Alvernia. I'm very excited to bring local artists, specifically local artists, not just people who are doing the work, which is also very important, but also to be able to show students and people inside of the community that Alvernia wants to highlight the people that are here and lift up the people that are here in our Berks County community, because there's so much talent here.
This is such a rich community within the arts and the culture. And really, I think any genre of art that is out there, we have significant talent here in this community. Sometimes it's a little hidden. I don't want to say purposely or not purposely, but we need to lift up our local artists. And through what Alvernia is doing and many of our community organizations and bringing our local artists out and giving them the opportunity to feature what their talent is so important here in Berks County. And bringing our students into that, because our students, you know, some may just think that this is a hobby or it's just something that they're doing on the side, but through these education programs, they can really see how it can become a profession and a career for them, Or somebody say, well, I really want to be an engineer, but I really love playing the piano. So how can I blend the two of those together? And we show them those ways that they can do that through not only our programming, but the Reading Musical Foundation and through what our higher education institutions are offering locally. You get this nice blend. And we're continuing to build our audience then of our young people mm-hmm. moving into adulthood that are coming in who are going to be our future performers, so mm-hmm. which is really awesome.
And our future doctors and our lawyers. And so yes. much of the arts, the experience of being an artist is one thing, but also the experience of experiencing the art is something right. that is equally as powerful. Mm-hmm. And through arts education, not just the doing of it, but the experiencing of it, we are creating people who are thinking and engaging right. and developing holistically, which is so exciting and mm-hmm. so much what we need in our world these days.
Right, right. And I've known Jessica for a very long time. I won't say how long, but I've known her for since, let's just say, we were wee ones together. We'll just leave it at that. And I've watched her grow personally as an artist. And I think, like many artists, as students, you gain some practice in your skill here, but then you move away. But then you come back. And then you share your gifts back with your community. And I think that's really awesome. And why don't you share a little bit about your journey as an artist, and then we'll kind of go into your recent performance.
Thank you. Thank you. So I trained at Brooks Ballet Theater when I was growing up. Mm-hmm. And then I did leave mm-hmm. after I became a professional performer. I danced all around the East Coast. I spent the past 10 years in Philadelphia working with two professional companies, a contemporary ballet company and a contemporary modern dance company. Mm-hmm. With those companies, I toured nationally, I traveled internationally, and then I started getting commissions to do my own work. Mm-hmm. And a lot of the commissions to do my own work were inside communities that had people who were also dancers, but maybe didn't have as robust mm-hmm. community as Philadelphia did. And so as I was doing this work, I kept wondering, why couldn't I, or maybe mm-hmm. I could do this work mm-hmm. in the Reading area, because I was traveling a lot mm-hmm. to work with different populations and work with different communities. And so coming back to Reading has been such a joy and such a thrill mm-hmm. To find the many gems that are here right. and the talent and the interest specific. Yes, absolutely, in the Birch Jazz Fest, and the visual art community here is so strong. But also I'm finding that there are a lot of dancers here.
A tremendous
as well.
Amount of dancers.
And so I'm really interested in finding out who these dancers are and how do we communicate together, and how do we mm-hmm. lift up this art form comprehensively. Because mm-hmm. dance, one of the things that I do, so at Alvernia, which I don't think I said yet, I'm managing director of the Art Series, mm-hmm. but I'm also artist in residence. And one of my jobs as artist in residence is find the ways that dance can build a bridge between the arts and other disciplines. Mm-hmm. So for example, something that we did last year was we collaborated with some environmental studies folks, mm-hmm. and we collaborated with the campus ministry, and we had a celebration of World Water Day. Mm. And so there was movement, there was prose, there was some visual art related to mm-hmm. water and social justice issues. And so there are other ways to experience social justice and community building that the arts can facilitate, mm-hmm. and that's something that I'm very interested in. My company, JCWK Dance Lab, right. Those are my initials, JCWK, okay. Jessica Claire Warchal-King, but they also stand for joy, connection, and wellness mm-hmm. through kinesthetic stories. And so I believe that our bodies tell our stories, like everything we do, whether we hide or if we have a lump in our throat right. when we're upset, our bodies are telling us something. And as a contemporary artist, I abstract that movement mm-hmm. Into a concert form. And it's not something that everybody has to understand, but sometimes it's the letting go of wanting to understand. Right. I had a dancer in my most recent performance say, don't try and wrap your head around it, try and wrap your heart around it. Mm-hmm. And I think with all art, that becomes so important right. to give ourselves permission to wrap our heart around the experience. And maybe not think so much about it.
Yeah, and you really open your mind. When you open your mind, you open your heart, you open your soul to really experience something new and very different. I know I attended your last performance, and I had a guest with me. She's like, I'm not really sure if I'm going to understand this. And I said, just let your mind go free. And then when she was able to do that, instead of asking all these questions, it was like, oh, now I get it. And it's really about personal reflection within that art form. And it was just beautiful. But the Arts and Culture Series is definitely that is something that has been growing at Alvernia. The arts, as I've always said, has kind of ebbed and flowed at Alvernia University, and it is so wonderful to see the university take a strong commitment and a strong step in fostering all of the different arts and really creating a beautiful theater atmosphere that holds a little over 200 guests. Mm-hmm. And the stage, I mean, can be small or it could be large, but you can interact with your audience in each performance. And I think that is a wonderful asset for our community as we continue to bring more arts programming here, or really lifting up the arts programming that is here. Mm-hmm. But you are bringing in Jill Haley with Winds of Badlands.
Yes.
Why don't you share a little bit about that and the performance? And it's going to be on Tuesday, February 4th?
Yes.
Okay.
Tuesday, February 4th at 7:30 in Francis Hall Theater. And again, like you said, Francis Hall does seat 200 people, and that seems like a large number, but because of the way that the theater mm-hmm. is structured, it feels very intimate.
Right.
And that creates a very special environment for the audience. Not something that every theater does, mm-hmm. in terms of having the thrust stage, but it's a unique experience, mm-hmm. and I think it really reflects Alvernia's mission in encompassing community and encompassing the whole person,
right.
and allowing everybody to have a unique individual experience and understand mm-hmm. Who they are as a full person.
Right.
So Jill Haley's Winds of Badlands. Jill Haley has traveled all over mm-hmm. the country. She has done artistic residencies in national parks across the country and is very interested in preserving these national parks through her music and bringing awareness to the importance of sustainability mm-hmm. and environmentalism through her work. And so I'm so excited to have her come on February 4th at 7:30 to Alvernia. She will also be performing with David Cullen, who is a Grammy Award-winning musician, and pianist Sue McDevitt, who is, and both of them are local. And so again, I think it's so exciting to be lifting up the mm-hmm. local voices of our community.
Absolutely. And we do have a quick image of the announcement that if we want to flash that up on the screen, there we go. Again, Dave Cullen, another local musician that is very well known here locally, will be joining Jill this year. So Tuesday, February 4th,
yes.
7:30. Tickets for this event?
Tickets can be found online.
Okay.
alvernia.edu/artsandculture.
Great. And available, are they also available at the door, or is
yes.
everything in advance?
Nope, you can get them at the door as well.
Okay, and do you have student pricing?
We do.
Okay.
We have prices for Alvernia students, and we have prices for students who are not Alvernia students. And
great.
That has a broad range of meaning.
Yes, absolutely. And then this is really exciting. During Jazz Fest, and that's I'm not excited just because of that. I just think this performance is amazing. Jermaine Ingram and
yes.
the Red Rose Collective.
Yes. Yes.
Share about this multifaceted performance and how and why you brought this
sure.
to Alvernia Art.
So because I'm interested in dance, something that I've been really interested in is the history of jazz. And jazz dance has been integrally linked to mm-hmm. jazz music, as has tap dance, which is uniquely American and a
right.
unique fusion of movement. And so Jermaine Ingram is a dance scholar. She is a historian. She is a storyteller. She is able to bring all of the nuances of the history of tap dance and jazz and music and song and storytelling together in this comprehensive performance. So she's going to be joined by the Red Rose Collective. And I have this paper just so I get everybody's name right. Suzette Ortiz, Lynn Riley, Karen Smith, and Monette Sutter, who are all internationally renowned
right.
female artists. And I'm also very excited because this is all in conjunction with the Burke Celebration of Women in the Arts.
Mm-hmm.
And so Jermaine and the Red Rose Collective are specifically tailoring this performance to represent female voices, and they're designing it for the Frances Hall stage, which we've already talked about,
right.
And they're designing it with the idea of female voices in mm-hmm. mind. So the little blurb that she sent me is that they're sharing an evening of songs and percussive dances that speaks to the ways that women experience the senses, not just the five bodily senses, but ephemeral ones of joy and loss, of freedom, danger, time, space, gratitude. The artists call on their own original compositions reflecting diverse styles and heritages, as well as music composed or popularized by women to invite audiences to find closer connection with their own senses and feelings. And so it's going to be very multifaceted, multidimensional, and very, very exciting to kick off Berks Jazz Fest mm-hmm. and to literally kick off.
Literally going to kick off the Jazz Fest. It's being held Wednesday, March 11th yes. at 7:30.
Yes.
Tickets available for this yet?
Yep, absolutely. Okay. On the website and also at the door as well.
Okay, great. Awesome. So the Arts and Culture Series, this year there were four performances, a well breadth of experience, diversity, but there's another portion of the Arts and Culture Series that I think is just as important at Alvernia that people may not be aware of, and that is the student performances.
Absolutely.
Can we share just a little bit about that before we close our program tonight?
Absolutely. The students are all led by very distinguished faculty, mm-hmm. and we have several performances coming up. The theater play, we have a fall play and a spring play okay. every year. There are auditions for that, and our director, Nathan Thomas, is very intuitive and conscientious about the plays that he chooses. Mm-hmm. The theater play this spring will run April 28th through May 1st. And then additionally, we have a chorus and concert band.
Mm.
And students can participate in this for credit or not for credit.
Okay.
This is also open for community members and members of the Alvernia community. So wide range of experiences.
So anyone from the community can join the chorus or the band?
I'm going to say contact.
Contact.
Contact the Arts at Alvernia. Contact
yes.
Jennifer Mahalik if you're okay. interested in the chorus. And contact our Chair of the Fine Art and Performing Arts, Carol mm. Schwanger, if you're mm. interested in concert band. And come and join us and play with us, experience the arts. And the public concert band performance is going to be Saturday, May 9th at 3 p.m.
Okay. And those are also at Frances Hall?
Those are also in Frances Hall. Okay. The theater performances usually have a $5 charge, and the chorus and concert band concerts are free. In addition, mm-hmm. we have a visual art gallery.
Yes.
And we have rotating professional artists come in, but we also have student artists presenting inside the gallery and outside of the gallery. So there are a lot of opportunities to experience the arts as a community member, as a student, mm-hmm. as an audience member, and as somebody who wants to participate in performance and visual art.
Because I know the Miller Gallery, that is the
name. Yes, the Miller Gallery.
The Miller Gallery. Yep. It's great as you are maybe waiting for one of the performances to start, or if you're waiting for a meeting or something else to happen in Frances Hall. It's a great place just to go and enjoy the art. The student art has been really interesting and unique over the last few months that have been in there, both in the gallery and also in the lobby. And it really shows the students' progression from when they first started in the art class until the end of the art class, and how much they have fine-tuned their skills just even in that short period of time. And it's great that that progression is being done there in the gallery mm-hmm. as well. And I know you also have a lot of visiting artists that come in for the gallery. What is the website that people can log into, check out if they're interested in the Alvernia Arts and Culture Series?
Mm-hmm. www.alvernia.edu/arts and culture.
Great. And do you have a Facebook page?
We do have a Facebook page.
Okay.
Arts at Alvernia University. So like us, find us there, stay updated with all of our exciting events. We go out into the community, both our local community and the greater community, to different festivals and different experiences. So we're not just in our little university bubble, but we're connecting right. on a local and national level with other artists and other experiences, and also for offering those experiences to our students as well.
That is awesome. Well, Jessica, I cannot thank you enough for being with us here tonight. with the Berks Arts Council BCTV monthly program.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome. We appreciate the opportunity to feature the Arts and Culture series and share that with each and every one of you that is watching here tonight. Just as a reminder, get your Jazz Fest tickets now. If you want the really good seats and if you want a specific seat, get your Jazz Fest tickets. It is available on our website at jazzfest.com. All of our tickets are sold through Ticketmaster. So if there is another vendor out there selling our tickets, don't buy them. They're not our tickets. So next month, we'll be talking more about Jazz Fest and all of our programming that is be coming up in March. We wish you a great evening, a full month of January of fun. Enjoy the arts and culture that are here in Berks County. Good night.
BCTV receives state arts funding support through a grant from the Pennsylvania Council on the Arts, a state agency. Funded by the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania and the National Endowment for the Arts, a federal agency.